Space is an unforgiving place, so working and living up there is not easy. That also translates into the structures meant to support human life and activities being more functional and intent than comfortable and beautiful. Or, that's how things were until now, when the interior of the world's first commercial space station was unveiled for the world to see. The station's name is Haven-1, and it is a design by space startup Vast. We've known the place is coming for a while now, as the company has constantly released details about it. Today's topic covers the station's interior, but before getting into it, it's worth going through what we already know about Haven-1, aka Haven-1 Lab. The station is supposed to be launched next year, and it will be deployed in orbit to serve the needs of paying customers, be them private citizens, governments, or companies. There will be several modules making up the habitat, as in all other space stations, but unlike all others, one of these modules will be spinning to some degree. This should allow it to provide occupants with gravity, not as much as on Earth, but enough to earn it the title of world's first microgravity research station. The place will be 100 meters long and it will comprise 4 private crew quarters, a common area, and the lab, complete with 10 mid-deck locker equivalent payload slots, each of them the size of a microwave and capable of supporting payloads weighing as much as 66 pounds. Haven-1 will be connected to the ground by means of the Starlink system. The station will be supplied with both crew and those required to live and work with the help of a SpaceX Crew Dragon. As said, this video is about the station's interior, thanks to some details and images Vast released earlier this week. And just a quick glance at it all is enough to have you believe you're not on a space station, but inside a luxury space hotel. All the magic happens as soon as astronauts reach the Haven-1. The main corridor that connects the Crew Dragon with the rest of the structure greets its occupants with a real-time display that shows critical data about station status, with temperature and lighting controls. The crew quarters are located above and below the main corridor. All 4 are allegedly a tad larger than the ones available on the International Space Station, and they have been uniquely designed to allow for changing, entertainment, online communication, the latter 2 handled with the help of the Starlink. Each room will be equipped with a patent-pending sleep system that's about the size of a queen bed, and should provide astronauts with a customized amount of equal pressure on their bodies. Both side and back sleepers should feel just like home on these beds. Each room will also have its own built-in storage compartment, vanity, and a custom amenities kit. The common area, which has a volume of 848 cubic feet, is where astronauts will gather to eat meals on a multi-use table that folds into the floor, relax, and exercise. Workout possible thanks to the fitting of a resistance band system. This piece of technology has been specifically designed to allow astronauts to stay in shape while in zero gravity, and comes complete with body and station anchors. It can be used to train bones, muscles, and the cardiovascular system through both linear and rotational resistance exercises. One of the most exciting features of the common area, and something of a first, is the centralized domed window measuring 3.6 feet that should allow an unobstructed view of the planet below. Last but not least comes the lab of the station, the module that will actually support microgravity research. Utilitarian in design, it comes with a pretty neat feature. Some of the experiments conducted in there can be performed remotely, and that should open up entirely new avenues of research in many fields. But that's more about layout than about how the station will actually feel for its occupants. Vast considered this aspect as well, so the Haven-1 will come with never-before-seen features such as soft and padded surfaces, but also fire-resistant maple wood veneer to make the place feel more like home and warmer. Vast says the design of the station's interior was handled by former Apple designer Peter Russell Clark with help from NASA astronaut Andrew Feustel. It may not look like much, compared to what we can do here on Earth, but in the world of space stations, it's unlike anything we've seen before. And that makes us pretty exciting of having it up and running so soon. Together with the interior, Vast also presented some details for Haven-2, the perceived successor of the ISS. We'll discuss this second station in a separate video,